In this presentation, I'll be showing you the basic positioning guidelines and routine views for the radiographic examination of the skull. Essential projections include the lateral, the PA, PA axial Caldwell method, AP, AP axial or reverse Caldwell, AP axial Towne method, PA axial Haas method, and the SMV or submento vertex view. For the lateral projection, the patient can be positioned upright or recumbent. If recumbent, use of a radiographic wedge sponge is recommended to help eliminate rotation or tilt. Place the MSP parallel to the table in the IR. The interpupillary line should be perpendicular to the IR, with the infraorbital meatal line parallel to the transverse axis of the IR. Direct the central ray to enter 2 inches superior to the EAM and collimate to at least a 10 by 12 inch field crosswise. Take the time to view your patient's position in multiple planes. Rotation for the skull occurs when the head is turned right or left, as in the image on the top right of this slide. Tilt is when the top of the cranium is angled away from the MSP, like in the image below it. One thing that helps me distinguish the two is during tilt, you make this motion when eating a taco. I like to call it taco neck, where you tilt your head to one side in order to take a bite. Rotation is what you do before you cross the street by looking both ways. The PA and PA axial Caldwell methods are very similar, except for the PA axial Caldwell has a tube angulation, while the straight PA has a perpendicular beam. The part positions are identical, though, and the images on the right on this slide include the PA view only. The patient can be upright or prone with the MSP centered to midline of the IR. Placing the forehead and nose against the table or upright bucky generally places the OML perpendicular to the IR. Small adjustments may be needed depending on the patient. The central ray should be perpendicular to the IR and exit the nasion for the PA view. For the PA axial Caldwell position, the patient can be either upright or supine with the OML perpendicular to the table or upright bucky. The tube should be angled 15 degrees caudal for this view, and the CR should still exit the nasion. Both PA and PA axial Caldwell views should be performed with a 10 by 12 inch field or smaller. Note the images on the right. The top image is the PA axial Caldwell. This can be distinguished from the straight PA view shown on the bottom because the petrous ridges fill the lower one-third of the orbits. In the PA view, the petrous ridges completely fill the orbits. Both of these views can be performed AP as well as with the patient supine and the CR centering at the nasion. For the reverse Caldwell or AP axial, the tube would need to be angled 15 degrees cephalic in the AP projection. One noticeable difference in the radiographic presentation is the orbits will be significantly more magnified when performing these AP. Next, we have the AP axial Towne's view. For this one, you may place the OML or the IOML perpendicular to the IR with the patient supine or seated upright. Depending on which of these positioning lines you utilize, the degree of angulation for the tube will vary. If using the OML, angle the tube 30 degrees caudal. If using the IOML, use 37 degrees caudal. The central ray should exit through the foramen magnum. Collimate to a 10 by 12 inch field size. The skull will be elongated in this view, and if performed correctly, the dorsum sella should be visible within the foramen magnum. A similar view can be performed with the PA axial Haas method. The patient is placed prone or sitting upright facing the wall bucky. Place the OML perpendicular to the IR and angle the tube 25 degrees cephalic. Center at a point 1 1/2 inches below the external occipital protuberance. This should cause the CR to exit about 1 1/2 inches superior to the nasion. Collimate to a 10 by 12 inch field size or smaller. The submento vertex position, or the SMV Schüller method, is probably the most difficult position for the patient to hold while sitting upright. Although there are methods to perform this supine with the torso elevated, the neck is extended so the IOML is parallel with the IR, with the MSP centered. the CR should be perpendicular to the IR and pass through the MSP between the angles of the mandible, which projects it through the sella turcica. Another centering reference could be stated as 3/4 inch anterior to the level of the EAM at midline. Collimate to a 10x12 inch field or less. Be cautious not to clip the anatomy of the occipital bone in this projection, since you will not be able to see the light field on the posterior aspect of the cranium.